हाय नैना, वी वर लर्निंग अबाउट पीएच स्केल इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो. वी लर्न अबाउट पीएच स्केल, सम कॉन्सेप्ट अबाउट पीएच स्केल. सो वी विल कंटिन्यू सम मोर पॉइंट्स. सी एक्चुअली द पीएच स्केल, दिस इज नोन एज पीएच स्केल. पीएच स्केल विल हेल्प अस टू मेजर द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ द एसिड्स और बेसिस. Okay, so based on the amount of hydrogen ion concentration, so the strength of acidic nature or basic nature can be expressed. So for this purpose, a pH scale is designed. So the pH scale contains values from 0 to 14. Range of pH scale is from 0 to 14. So at the middle, in the middle, you will find 7. If the pH value is 7, then the solution is said to be neutral solution. Okay, so then its hydrogen ion concentration will be 10 to the power of minus 7. Hydrogen ion concentration will be 10 to the power of minus 7 and pH will be 7, then it is said to be neutral solution. So if hydrogen ion concentration increases from minus 7 to minus 6, from minus 6 to minus 5, so like this, in this direction, what is happening? So the hydrogen ion concentration, the negative powers are decreasing. That means hydrogen ion concentration is increasing. So if hydrogen ion concentration is increasing, then pH value decreases from 7 to 6, 6 to 5. So like this, pH value decreases. Okay. If hydrogen ion concentration increases, then the value of pH decreases. So if pH value decreases, what is happening? So the acidic nature increases. So in this direction, as we move in this direction, increasing order of acidic nature. This is the direction of increasing order of acidic nature. Suppose if there are two substances, X and Y, for example, substance X, pH is 6 and substance Y, its pH is 4, so the substance, which substance pH is more, that substance is less acidic in nature. So here the pH value I am giving, so pH of X is 6 and pH of Y is 4, therefore Y is strong acid than X, so acidic strength, if I write acidic strength, then Y is strong acid than X because Y is having less pH value than X. So like that. So if you move in this direction, that means the hydrogen ion concentration is still further decreasing. When hydrogen ion concentration decreases, what happens? So the pH value is increasing. So in this direction, pH value is increasing and hydrogen ion concentration decreases. So if hydrogen ion concentration is decreasing, what happens? OH minus ion concentration increases automatically. So that means if hydrogen ion concentration is less than OH minus ion concentration, then the solution is basic in nature. Its pH value will be greater than 7. So here as we move from left to right, after 10 to the power of minus 7, so what is happening to the hydrogen ion concentration? It is gradually decreasing. Its pH value gradually increases. So like that, so pH value will be greater than 7. So all these values are greater than 7 only. So this range is said to be basic range. So this is said to be basic range and this is said to be acidic range. So as we move from 7 to downwards towards 0, the acidic nature increases. As we move from 7 to upward towards 14, the basic nature increases. So towards this direction acidic nature increases, towards this direction basic nature increases. Okay, so like this. If H plus ion concentration is equal to OH minus ion concentration, the solution is neutral, therefore pH is equal to 7. For neutral solution, pH will be 7. Okay. If hydronium concentration is greater than OH minus ion concentration, that means H plus ions are more than OH minus ions. So the solution is acidic in nature. If the solution is acidic in nature, then the pH value will be less than 7. So all these values are less than 7 only. So these pH values are less than 7 up to here. So below 7, that means up to 6.9 also, it is somewhat acidic. Okay, if H plus ion concentration is less than OH minus ion concentration, that means hydroxide ions are more. If hydroxide ions are more, then the solution is basic in nature. Therefore, pH will be greater than 7. So this is basic in nature. So as we move from left to right after 7, so the basic nature of the substance increases. So the substance with a pH value 14 is stronger base than the substance whose pH value is 11. So like this, based on the pH scale, we can explain the strength of the acid or strength of the base. If H plus ion concentration increases, then the value of pH decreases. If H plus ion concentration increases, then the substance acidic nature increases. So in this direction, what is happening? H plus ion concentration is gradually increasing. Therefore, acidic nature of the substance also increases. Therefore, if pH increases, acidic nature decreases. If pH increases, basic nature increases. Okay, so with increase in pH, acidic nature decreases, but basic nature increases. So like this, these are the important points related to pH scale one should learn. Okay, and also we have learned how to find the pH of a given substance if hydronions are given. Okay, right. Now we will learn about the next concept, determination of pH with the help of indicators. So now we'll try to find the pH value with the help of indicators. So with the help of pH scale, with the help of pH scale, so we came to know how the acidic range of pH and basic range of pH will be. Now, okay. Now we will use we'll take the help of indicators for the determination of pH. So determination of pH by using the indicators. See, again I am drawing the pH scale. It varies from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. The pH scale contains the values ranging from 0 to 14. So these are the pH values. Okay. Right. So now let us see different types of indicators. So actually indicators are of two types. Indicators, if you see, so these indicators are of two types. What are they? Common indicators. Common indicators. And another one is universal indicator. Universal indicator. Okay. common indicators and universal indicator. Universal indicator. So what are common indicators? Common indicators will help us to know whether the given solution is acidic or basic. Suppose I don't know, there is a solution. Suppose there is a solution, I want to know whether this substance is acidic or basic. In order to know whether the substance is acidic or basic, then I can use common indicators. So common indicators, examples, litmus solution, okay, methyl orange is another common indicators. Phenolphthalein is another common indicator. So like this, these are some of the common indicators generally we use in our laboratory, to tell whether the solution is acidic or alkaline in nature. Okay, to tell whether the solution is acidic or alkaline in nature, so we take the help of these indicators known as common indicators. Okay, so suppose if I put litmus solution into this substance, if I put few drops of litmus solution into this substance, if the color of the substance changes to red, by addition of litmus solution into this one, okay, then the solution is said to be acidic solution. So this solution is said to be acidic solution. So with acids, what is happening? So when litmus is added to acid, so immediately the color of litmus solution will change to red. So litmus solution, the color of litmus solution will immediately will change to red. So that means this entire solution will turn to red color. If the solution is turning to red color due to the conversion of litmus solution into red by the reaction of litmus solution with acid, so now the color of this indicator is changing. What is indicator actually? Indicator is a substance which undergo changes in color with acids or with bases. The substance which undergo changes in color by reacting with acids or bases is said to be indicators. So litmus solution is one of the indicator. So if we add litmus solution to a substance, if the color of the substance is changed to red, so it indicates that the solution is acidic in nature. Suppose if the color of solution, if it is turned to blue instead of red, it is turned to blue, then the solution it is said to be alkaline in nature or else basic in nature. The solution is base or alkaline in nature. So in this way, with the help of litmus solution, we can find whether the given solution is acidic solution or basic solution. Even with methyl orange also. So with methyl orange, see litmus solution, what happens? The litmus solution in base will turn to blue color. Suppose if you take methyl orange, If you take methyl orange, so in acidic it is red color, but in basic solution, in the basic solution methyl orange turns to yellow in color. Okay, if you take phenolphthalein, if you take phenolphthalein, so in acidic solution it remains colorless. Actually, the color of the phenolphthalein is colorless only. The actual color of phenolphthalein solution is colorless. Okay, so it remains colorless only with acid. That means phenolphthalein cannot identify, or else phenolphthalein cannot change its color when it combines with acid. But the same phenolphthalein, when it is mixed with base, what happens? The color of the phenolphthalein will change into pink color. So if I add phenolphthalein, HPH, generally phenolphthalein is written as HPH. HPH means phenolphthalein. So if I add phenolphthalein into this one, the color of the solution will turn to pink. Then the solution is said to be basic in nature, or else alkaline in nature. Okay, so that means this phenolphthalein will turn to pink color with base. So in this way, these indicators will tell us whether the given substance is acidic substance or basic substance. Simply they tell that whether the given substance is acidic or basic. Such indicators are said to be common indicators. See, if you look into the litmus solution, it does not show color. Here the range of litmus solution, if I take what is this one, litmus solution, so here from 0 to 5 pH, if the solution's pH is from 0 to 5, so the solution color is red. If the solution pH is 5, it is red. If 4 also it is red, 3 also it is red, 2 also it is red. Even the solution pH is 1 or 0 also it is red in color. That means, so these are all acidic ranges. So that means with any stripe of strong acid or even weak acid also, it is showing red in color. Red color only. That means it cannot differentiate the strong acid from the weak acids. It cannot differentiate. Simply it tells whether the solution is acidic solution or not. If it turns to red, then the solution is said to be acidic, simply. And here, this is the basic range from 7 and above 7. It is basic range. Okay, so in basic range, the color of the this litmus solution will be blue. So here in between range from 5 to 7, so what is happening? The litmus solution will undergo change in color. The litmus solution will undergo change in color. That means there is no definite color. So below 5 pH, the litmus solution's color is red, and above 7 pH, the litmus solution color is blue. And between this range, between 5 to 7, the litmus solution's color, we cannot detect the color, because it keeps on changing its color. That means it changes its color starting from pH 5 to 7. So it changes its pH. So litmus paste solution, so this is important question. So litmus solution will changes its will start changing its color from which pH to which pH, from pH 5 to pH 7. Suppose if you take methyl orange solution indicator, if you take methyl orange indicator, then its pH range will be change will be between 3 to 4 the pH. So here there is a change in color, change in color, that means the indicator do not work, okay, do not work in this range. The indicator does not work, that means between 3 and 4, between pH 3 and 4. So above 4 the methyl orange color will be yellow in color, okay, and below 4 the methyl orange color will be red in color. So the original color of methyl orange, so what is this about methyl orange? The original color of methyl orange is orange in color. So that the same methyl orange, if it is kept, if it is poured into acid, then its color changes to red. If it is poured into base, its color changes to yellow. If you take phenolphthalein, HPH, see what happens to phenolphthalein. See, up to pH 6 above, up to pH 6 above from here, somewhere from here. Okay, up to 8. So what happens? So the color of the pH, the color of the phenolphthalein will change. So there is a change in color of the phenolphthalein. So below 6 or else 6.5, so the phenolphthalein is colorless. It is colorless. The color of phenolphthalein itself is a colorless. So even in its in the pH range from 0 to 6.5, that means in acidic range also the color of the phenolphthalein remains as colorless only. That means this phenolphthalein is not useful to identify the whether the given substance is acidic or not. But the same phenolphthalein is used to identify whether the given substance is base or not, we can easily identify. So with the help of phenolphthalein, we can identify the base, but we cannot identify the acid. Hence, the phenolphthalein is said to be indicator of the base. So hence phenolphthalein, it is called as indicator of the base. So special indicator for base is phenolphthalein. So litmus solution and methyl orange, they work both in acidic range as well as in basic range also. But phenolphthalein, it works only in the basic range. So it gives good results only with the base, not with the acid. So like this, so these are the indicators, common indicators, which helps us to know whether the given substance is acidic substance or basic substance. Okay. These common indicators cannot tell us what is the pH of the given substance. So it is simply telling that it is acidic. Acidic solution means, so what is its pH value? So its pH value may be from 0 to 5 or else 0 to 7. So like that. But it is not specifically, it is not telling, so that means these indicators are not telling, they are not telling what is the pH value of this solution. Then how to know the pH value of the given solution? Simply, these common indicators are telling that the given solution is acidic solution. Acidic solution means, if pH is equal to 0 also it is acidic. If pH is equal to 1 also it is acidic. pH is equal to 2 also it is acidic. pH is equal to 3 also it is acidic. So like that. So like that, if pH values up to below 7. So up to below 7, all these are acidic ranges only. So common indicators does not help us to tell what is the pH value of this particular solution. Simply tells that this solution is acidic. So then how to know the exact pH value of the given solution? So only universal indicators helps us to know the pH value of the given substance. Okay, universal indicators helps us to know the pH value of the given substance. So it universal indicator works, it changes its color with a change in pH. Universal indicator, so it gives, that means it changes into it gives different colors, it gives different colors with different pH values with solutions of different pH values. So solution of different pH values. So that means different pH values will have different colors. Suppose, so I'm removing this common litmus, common indicators. So now I'm drawing about, I'm drawing a pH scale based on the universal indicator. So the pH scale based on the universal indicator, if it is drawn, so so this is what, this is acidic range up to 7, it is acidic range and 7, exactly 7, it is neutral and above 7 up to 14, it is basic range or alkaline range. Okay, right. So now if you add, suppose if there is a solution and we don't know, so the pH value of solution, if you want to find the pH value of solution, so we should not use common indicators, we have to use universal indicator, because universal indicator it gives different colors with colors of solution with different pH values. So that means if a solution is having different color, specific color, that specific color indicates the specific pH value. It gives different colors with different pH values. Sorry. It gives different colors of the solution to the solution. It gives different colors to the solution of solutions of different pH values, different colors to the solutions having different pH values, solutions having different pH values. Suppose here if you add this universal indicator into this solution, if the solution's color changes to green, if the color of the solution is changed to green when universal indicator is added, so what has happened? So the it indicates what? It indicates that the given substance is neutral substance. It is neither acidic nor basic. So that means here the universal indicators, if it turns to green, the given solution is said to be neutral in nature. Hence its pH value will be 7. So the for pH value 7, the universal indicator, so its color will be green color. For what? For pH is equal to 7, the color of the universal indicator will be 7. Okay. So for pH 5, the color is yellow. So yellow color indicates what? Suppose if the solution is turned to yellow, in color, then the pH of the solution is said to be 5. If the solution is turned to orange in color, then the pH of the solution is said to be 3. Okay. If the solution is turned to red in color, then the pH of the solution is said to be 1. So like this, different solutions with different pH values will turn to different colors. So that means it gives, the universal indicator gives different colors to the solutions having different values of pH. Okay, so now if the solution is having pH value 1, then when you add to that universal indicator to that solution, then the solution will turn to red in color. So like that. Suppose if the solution color is changed to blue, when does the solution's color changes to blue? If the pH of the solution is 9, so before that it was acidic in nature. Now if pH is called 9, so it is basic in nature now. So if pH is 9, then the universal indicator turned to blue. So turning of this solution into blue color indicates that its pH value is exactly 9. Okay. Suppose if the pH value is 6, then what will be the color of the solution after addition of universal indicator? So it's the color of the indicator will be ranging from yellowish to green, or it's greenish to yellow. If the color of solution is changed, changes to greenish yellow or yellowish green, then the pH of the solution is said to be having 6. The solution is said to be having pH value of 6. So like that. So that means here universal indicators helps us to know whether the given solution is acidic or not, and also along with that it also explains, it also tells us the pH value of the given solution also. So these substances cannot tell the pH values. These substances will tell whether the given solution is acidic or not. But this indicator will tell us the pH values of the given substance. So in this way, determination of pH by using the indicators, we can determine the value of pH by using the indicators. So if the universal indicator, suppose if the pH of this solution is 9, then when we add universal indicator to that solution, it turns to blue, already we have seen. Okay, suppose if the pH value of the solution is 11, then the color of the solution is indigo color. If the pH of the solution is, suppose if it is 13, then the color of the solution will be violet. So if violet color develops in the solution, then we can simply say that the pH value of this solution is 13. That means it is a strong base. Okay, violet. It's a strong base. So if a solution having violet color is stronger base than the solution having indigo color. Okay, then the solution having indigo color with universal indicator, it is stronger base than the solution having blue color, okay, with the universal indicator. So like this we can tell the pH values of the given substance with the help of indicators. See, that means universal indicator is more sensitive than common indicators. Universal indicator is more sensitive than common indicators because it goes beyond something and helps us to know the pH values also. But these indicators, they cannot help us to tell the pH value. Simply these indicators, common indicators, helps us to know whether the given substance is acidic or basic. Okay. So that means if it is green in color with a universal indicator, so it indicates for pH value 7 only, the solution will color it, will change it to green color. Hence the solution is said to be neutral in nature. So like that we can determine the pH with the help of indicators, right? Now let us learn the importance of pH. So in the next class we will learn about the importance of pH.